Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
How are you? All right?
Good. Welcome along to the Palace and to the 1986 Australian Songwriters Association Song Contest. What a mouthful. I'm Daryl Cotton and I'm going to be your host for the evening. Marty Monster sends his regards. Sorry he couldn't make it. We hope you're going to have a good time. You're going to enjoy yourselves. I was lucky enough to be involved last year with the Song Contest, and it was a resounding success, and all the organisers have got together this year and assured me of a similar evening. In fact, I believe the entries this year was a record amount. I'll get the president very shortly to come out and tell you a little bit about that. We've got quite a night of entertainment, and perhaps I'll do that now. I'll get Dominic to come out, the president of the Australian Songwriters Association, Dominic Crear.
I know you're out there. I can hear you breathing. Where's the box? Your Royal Highness, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and fellow songwriters. On behalf of the committee, welcome to the 1986 Australian Songwriters Association Annual Song Contest. What a mouthful, eh? By now, most of you know that we've had some 420 entries from all over Australia, which is something like three times the number that we had last year, which is a tremendous effort, really. 420 versus about 120. This achievement would not be possible without the support of the media and in particular, Eon FM. Lee, where are you? Somewhere up there. Thanks very much for what you've done, mate. Also, to bring this night together, it takes a lot of people and it takes a lot of that stuff they call money, I think. And we're a non-profit organisation, we need sponsors, and I'd like to thank at this stage the sponsors for this song contest. I'm nearly getting there. Which is World Register of Copyright, as in Rock, Victorian Audio Education Centre, Showbiz College, Silkwood Recording Studios, Ron Lee's Music Factory, and his new venture, which is Rock School, the Roland Corporation, Arc Sound, Maiton Guitars, APRA, Action Publishing Company, Ram Recording Studio, and of course, again, Eon FM. Thank you. Before I hand you back to Daryl, hello, Daryl. The song draw for the night was basically done like this. We had an independent panel of scrutineers to actually go through all the 12 finalists, okay, put them in a hat, and then my kids pulled them out. Okay, no correspondence will be entered into this method. And besides, Savas, wherever you are, I don't think you can take legal action against minors, can you? Okay, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the night, and I hand you back to Daryl. Thank you.
Thanks, Dominic. Almost sounded like a closing speech, didn't it? Like it was all over. Anyway, as Dominic said, yes, we've had a record amount of entries, and congratulations to everyone who made it to this stage, which is obviously the finals. Four categories, the same as last year. Pop, middle of the road, country, and our rock category. There are a couple of special categories that we'll tell you about a little bit later on in the evening as well. All the contestants are vying for a $250 prize in each category, as well as a very special $500 prize for the overall winner. And once again, thanks to Eon FM for their $500 encouragement award, which is another award, which goes hand in hand with the Rudy Brasmar Memorial Award, which is a perpetual trophy that's handed on from year to year. I think I've just about covered it all. Just like to say, we hope you're going to enjoy yourselves. It's pretty hard these days for a lot of performers, writers, singers, to get an opportunity to perform. There's not much happening on television and things like that. So this is a terrific showcase and a terrific opportunity. So good luck to all the guys. It's like a waiting room in a maternity hospital back there. They're pacing up and I was too, actually, pacing up and down. So we won't keep them waiting any longer. Once again, good luck to all of them. We're going to start off with the pop category first of all, and I'll refer to my little list to get things going. Song number one is a song entitled Remember. The lyrics and the music are by Scott Robin, and I'll invite Scott to come out now on stage and get himself ready. It's performed by Scott Robin. He's a Williamstown boy, where I come from as well now, and he's backed up by Steve Heath. Good luck, Scott. Well done, Scott, and thanks to Steve on vocal backing. Probably thought I forgot the judges, didn't you? Well, I did. Oh, sorry, guys. I better introduce our four distinguished guests who haven't got a very easy task tonight. I wouldn't like to be up there. As we said before, there was a number of judges involved in actually getting it down to this stage, but the four that we've got with us tonight helping out I'll just quickly introduce to everyone. First guy is a friend of mine. I like to call him a friend anyway, most of the time. His career goes back 30, 40, 50 years maybe. No, only about 20 actually. He's started out in rock and roll bands like most of us do, and is now probably one of the country's leading jingle writers and responsible for things like Up There Kazalie and the SPC Baked Beans commercial, which was one of my favourites. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Brady. Another friend, in fact they're all friends I think, another performer and currently working as head of the image publishing company. He's currently got a single out which is In the Name of Peace, which has been used as the theme for the upcoming papal visit. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome Paul O'Gorman. Also with us tonight is the director of Action Music, a new company that's doing good things around the country, Patrick Rosen. And finally, a guy who's had about four or five plugs already tonight. As I said before, he was involved in the song contest last year, knows a lot about music, and in fact is the musical director of the very successful Eon FM, Mr. Lee Simon. They're our judges, and they'll be keeping an eye on everyone throughout the night. Next up, song number two in our pop category is a song called Only Love Can Tell, and it's performed by Callum. I think I've got this right. Yes, I'm looking for the... Only Love Can Tell. Callum actually was in the song contest last year in the finals with a song called Modern Love. He's back this year with a song called Only Love Can Tell. He's got a couple of mates with him. Oh, is this right? Have I got this in order? Yes, I have. Sorry. He's got Jan Dawson and Peter Kent backing him up. Would you welcome, please, Callum Hammond with Only Love Can Tell. Love can tell.
think I know why. Only love, yes, only love, and well, I think I know the reason why. Yes, there's only love, and that's about all I can really say. Yes, that's been time, only love can say. Only love can tell, only love can tell. 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 Thank you. Thank you.
There we go with song number two, Only Love Can Tell, Callum Hammond. Our final song in this first category, the pop category, is a song entitled Show Me. And David Gillard is the writer and performer. David, if you want to come out and get yourself organised. He asked me to give him a few seconds to get everything right. He's also joined by couple of mates that I believe they came along just to see the show, and they got roped in as vocal backing. It's Peter Watts and Robert McKay. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome David Gillard with song number three, Show Me.
I'm
show me to your hiding place. Show me, won't you show me your face? What have I got as if you don't know? Nothing to hide, nothing to show. Show me, what are you waiting for? Show me, what's behind the door? Show me, show me, show me, ah, show me, ooh, show me, ah, show me,
show me. Oh, he's a tall one, isn't he?
Yeah.
Actually, I've been asked to do something else while I'm out here. We weren't seeing enough of our backing vocalists. I'm going to ask the guys to come out, the writers and performers, Scott Robin, Callum Hammond and David Gillard, just to receive their certificates, which says that this is to certify that whoever was a finalist in the Australian Songwriters Association Song Contest for 1986. Congratulations, guys, and a little bit later on the night, we'll know the good news. All right, we're going to move into the next category, which is the country music. And first one up tonight is a song entitled It's About Time. It's written and performed by a guy who was actually a judge here last year. Liked it so much, he decided he'd enter the competition and has made it through to the finals. He's a very talented singer and country music, known in the country music industry, and he's done a lot of help for the association. So would you please welcome, with It's About Time, Mr. Cash Backman.
It's about time we did some talking. It's about time we did some things. Cause I won't have you walking out the door with my wedding ring. Given to you with love and affection and a heart that's so, so true. So it's about time we started talking before it's the last thing we want to do. Well, it's about time we did some thinking. It's about time we change some views. What gives you the right to be winking at a man who ain't even yours? Now I don't think that I'm being foolish. My imaginings ain't new. So it's about time we did some talking before it's the last thing we want to do. Well, it's about time we started listening to our hearts beating out of time. Don't you dare say I'm overacting, that my thoughts are way out of line. If you stand there, keep on twisting all the words that come from you, then it's about time we started talking before it's the last thing we want to do. It's about time. Well, it's about time we had a sit down. It's about time you told me all. My head is tired of spinning round. I'm afraid that I might fall. Well, 1 minute you're on fire, then so cold you turn me blue. So it's about time we started talking before it's the last thing we want to do. Well, it's about time we started listening to our hearts beating out of time. Don't you dare say I'm overacting, that my thoughts are way out of line. If you stand there, keep on twisting all the words that come from you. It's about time we started talking before it's the last thing we want to do. If you stand there, keep on twisting all the words that come from you. It's about time we started talking before it's the last thing we want to do. That it's about time we started talking before it's the last thing we want to do.
Cash Backman, well done. All right, song number two in the country category is entitled The Gambler and the Lady. Now, the lyrics were written by Marie Murphy, who was also a finalist last year with her song The Rainbow Chaser. They've given me a bit of information here. The song was entered in a Tamworth song contest, won the Star Maker Quest, and was recorded by a young lady called Jane Maddock, who I've worked with, and made the country charts right around Australia. So Marie was very successful with that. That was The Rainbow Chaser from last year. This year she's teamed up with Dominic Crea, our president, who dabbles in all kinds of music, it says, between his commitments here with the Australian Songwriting Association. Anyway, they got together and they've written a duet. And tonight, The Gambler and the Lady are being performed by Tess McKenna and Laurie Nichols. Would you welcome them, please? Laurie might be a little while here. The gout finally got to him.
The table playing cards, and each had a winning hand. She held two pairs of sevens and tens. History needed a queen. He was gambling all his tomorrows, she was gambling all her dreams. Well, lady, I've gambled, I've won and I've lost, and it never mattered before. Now I'm sitting here hoping the next card I deal is the card you're looking for. She looked at the gambler and he saw her smile as she reached out to take his hand. And across the haze of a smoke-filled bar, she said to the gambling man,
I don't want a jack, give me false hopes and let me think that I can win. I don't want an ace with its place at the top, and I don't want a two-faced king. I don't want a club, cause I've seen them all, and diamonds are not my line. But I'll have a heart if you've one to spare for this lonely heart of mine.
The gambler looked beyond a painted face to her eyes, and he saw the dream. And he knew that luck had dealt him a hand that he'd ride would give him his queen. He'd grown tired of living, living by chance, and he knew lonely years lay ahead. So across the haze of a smoke-filled bar, he smiled at her and said,
I won't give you a jack who will give you false hopes or let you think that you can win. I won't give you an ace with its place at the top. I won't deal a two-faced king. I won't give you a club, cause you've seen them all, and diamonds are not your life. But I'll have a heart if there's one to spare for this lonely heart of mine.
She was a nighttime lady, he was a gambling man. They played at cards on the table that night, and each held a winning hand. She found the heart she'd been searching for, and they dealt him his queen. In there tomorrow's a four of a kind, but in there tonight was a dream. In there tomorrow's a four of a kind, but in there tonight was a dream.
Thank you.
Trying for the sympathy vote, were you, Laurie? All right. Final song in this category, the country category, is a song entitled Lost for Words. The lyrics are by Paul Wilson and music by Les Gock. Anyone who remembers the 70s may remember Les. Les was a bass player with a band called Hush. Anyone remember Hush? Oh, yes. Young lady over there remembers Hush. Boney Maroney and all that stuff. Anyway, Les has got together with Paul and they've written this song, Lost for Words. And tonight it's performed by a lady who just wants to be known as Anna. Ladies and gentlemen, Anna with Lost for Words.
That my plane came in, I wished I was elsewhere, dying to see you again, but dreading you'd be there. I never made a longer walk than through that airport lounge towards the place I knew you'd be amongst that waiting crowd. But of all the crowded people there, I only saw one face, just as if you were the only person in that place. It all came back, how good you looked, how long I'd been away. How could I have believed there was something I could say? I'm lost for words, I've been so long away. All I'd rehearse, I'll probably never say. I could explain the things you've done. Not sure how you'd react. My temples pounded violently. Too late for turning back. I thought about the way I left, the hurtful things I'd said. Who would have blamed you if you'd come here for revenge? I would have understood if you turned and walked away, if you'd refused again. Instead you fell into my arms and sobs were all I heard. So once again I find myself completely lost for words. I'm lost for words, I've been so long away. I'm lost for words, I'll probably never say. I could explain the things you've heard, the things I've done, but I'm lost for words, I'm lost for words, I've been so long away, I'm lost for words, there's nothing I can say, so much to tell, that should be heard, I should speak now, but I'm lost for words, I'm lost for words.
Well done, Anna. Anna, I'll get you to stay here for a second and I'll ask our other writers to come out for the country section. If Cash could come out. And Dominic. Present them with their certificates for reaching the finals in the Australian Songwriters Association Song Contest. Cash.
Anna's going to...
Congratulations, everyone. Yes, Anna's accepting on behalf of Paul and Paul Wilson and Les Gock. Back a little bit later on to see who the winner is in our country category. All right, before we move on to our next one, which is the middle of the road category, I want to take this opportunity to introduce guys that are playing a pretty important part in tonight's performances, and that's the band. Where would we be without the band? Some familiar faces to all of you, I think. First of all, on lead guitar, Mr. John LaCorsia. You were here last year, weren't you, John? Of course you were. On bass guitar, Tony Mazziotto. Tony? And the infamous Mr. Graham Morgan on drums. That was an easy name. On our keyboard number one, John Gindamo. Did I get it right, John? Joe. I was worrying about the surname and blew the first name. Never mind. Sorry, Joe. And on keyboard number two, we've got Jeff Wood. Thanks, Jeff. And of course, leader, charts, musical director of the works, Mr. Greg Ellis. And finally, the guy that they all rely on, who's looking after front of house tonight, Mr. Mark Barry, our sound engineer. Hey! He can make them all sound bad. All right, we'll move now to our middle of the road category and three more songs. First up is by a songwriter called Stu Storm. He's a new and up-and-coming singer and songwriter, and he's got his composition tonight, one of the three grand finalists, and the song is entitled The Last Tear.
How could you face me and believe you ever wanted this kind of love? You've taken back all your Polaroids and you kept my little glove. I don't know what to say. The last time that I saw you, you were clutching your Bible. I don't know where to go. I feel like I should stay at home. So take the last tear that you cried for me. Set it in a picture frame for all the world to see. This could be the last song I ever write for you. How could you kiss me and believe you never wanted this guy to hurt? I'm sitting here, I got your letters out and your lipstick on my shirt. Ooh, I don't know what to say. The last time that I saw you, you were clutching your Bible. I don't know where to go. I feel like I should stay at home. Take the last tear that you cried for me and set it in a picture frame for all the world to see. This could be the last song that I ever write for you. Take the last tear that you cried for me. Set it in a picture frame for all the world to see. It's Saturday. And all the boys are begging you to come outside and play. Why aren't we dancing here tonight? You know, it's a celebration. Come outside. Would you come outside and play? Look at this space. Come outside. Would you come outside and play? Come outside. Ooh, ooh. Come outside. Won't you come outside and play? Come outside. One more time for Stuna. Come outside. Won't you come outside and play? Come outside. Thank you.
That was Stu Storm. Very good. Song number 8, which is our second one in the middle of the road category. Lyrics and music by Russell Beggs, and performing the song tonight, which is entitled Pain is the Price. Please welcome Russell Beggs.
Last night the cold wind blew, I lay in bed alone. Blankets all I had to keep me warm. The night is long and my dreams belong to you and me. Left alone with all those memories. The lines on my face tell of my age. The women and the booze and the money I made. Pain is the price I pay. The fear on my face, the tears in my eyes, clinging to the memory of the years gone by. Pain is the price I pay. Whoa, time has taught me right from wrong. Love was sweet, but now it's gone. I didn't know I was wrong. And whoa, let me go back to the start. Let me do what I did then. I wouldn't make that mistake again. Well, I'm living in this house we once shared together. Each room has a memory of its own. Like the fireplace with a log softly burning. And the love we share together lingers on. The lines on my face telling of my age. The women and the booze and the money I made. The pain is the price I paid. The fear on my face, the tears in my eyes, clinging to the memory of the years gone by. Pain is the price I paid. Whoa. Time has taught me right from wrong. Love was sweet, but now it's gone. I didn't know I was wrong. And whoa, let me go back to the start. Let me do what I didn't then. I wouldn't make that mistake again. I wouldn't make that mistake again. I wouldn't break your heart again.
Well done, Russell. Pain is the price. Our final song in this category is a song entitled Any Stronger Now, written by Rob Stambulic and performed, yes, Rob over there, are you? His family, anyway. And performed by Angela Bazoulis. Please welcome Angela and Any Stronger Now.
But to let this go on,
could have never imagined letting go. Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now? Now, now, oh, yeah. He's been thinking a long time, but I don't know if I should let this go on. He could have never imagined letting go. Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now?
Thanks, Angela. Well done. I'm going to call our three writers for those last three songs to come up on stage. Rob Stambulik, Russell Beggs and Stu Storm to receive their certificates for making it through to the finals. Guys, could you come up here and... Congratulations, guys. And we'll announce the winner of that category very shortly. All right, our fourth and final category, although I, as I said earlier, there is a couple of special categories that we'll get to when we do make the presentations, is our rock category. How are you doing so far? Everyone okay? Actually, there is some food over there. I shouldn't tell you this because we'd like you to sit and watch the performances, but there is a buffet service over there that you're welcome to go to. But anyway, moving along to our fourth and final category, which is the rock category. And once again, all the contestants are competing for the $250 grand prize, but the actual section prize, as well as the grand prize, which is $500. First of all, the first song, I'll change pages here, is by a guy called Norman Falvo. And the title of the song is Suicide.
Your only friend is a 6'5"3. Suicide. It's all the rage in dim bands. Suicide. a 40-story drop in, yeah, yeah, yeah. La 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 lo. La 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 lo. La 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 lo, yeah. La 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 la. Suicide. An overdose of morphine. Suicide. A fatal sniff of morphine. Suicide. 1,000 grams of phallus. Suicide. I head on with a lorry. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thanks, fellas. No wonder Don looked at me funny. I got that all screwed up. Am I allowed to say that? Lyrics and music by Norman Falvo. That I thought Norman was coming up to sing, but it wasn't. It was performed by Don Shepis and Michael Segan and Bill Kent. Don was the lead singer. So well done, fellas. Yep. Next song. Lyrics by David Seddon. Quite a team here. Music by Debbie Bignell and performed by Melinda Cherisoli. Did I get it right, Melinda? Yes? All right. And the song's entitled Lover, Lover, our second song in our rock category.
Maybe you don't.
Our final song for the evening in the rock category is a couple of guys. We said earlier how a lot of the entries have come from all over Australia, and this song is no exception. In fact, two guys hail from Tasmania. No Tasmanian jokes, all right? Anyway, the song is entitled Beyond the Moon, and the two fellas were actually members of two groups that I was pretty fond of. They did some terrific stuff a while back. The two groups were The Innocents and Beethoven, very commercial pop groups, but they were very good. And anyway, this song, Beyond the Moon, lyrics and music by David Minchin, and tonight it's performed by David and Greg Cracknell. Would you please welcome them?
Secretly vowed to create and invent and exceed their wildest dreams. To go beyond the moon, beyond the moon. Getting colder, we're growing older. Volvo's making cars, they're building a spaceship to reach for the stars. They're launching it soon. They need a young man to help steer past the moon. The professor looked at me.
Lyrics and music by David Minchin. David, I'll ask you to come back out on stage if you don't mind. You and also Debbie Bignell, David Seddon, the writers of Lover Lover, and also Norman Falvo. If you'd like to come out and get your certificates, everybody. Debbie and David. Congratulations, everyone. All right, they're our 12 songs for the evening. So we're going to take a very short intermission. Judges, it's over to you now, the unenviable task of picking the winners out of those categories. So we're going to take a very short break. You're welcome to go over and have something to eat if you haven't done so already. And we'll be back very shortly with some results for everyone. Thanks very much, everyone. Thanks, guys. All right, our intermission is over. Thanks for being patient. We've assembled our judges out the back and they've made their final decisions. I mentioned earlier there was a couple of other categories. In fact, there were three other categories, sections, that we were going to make presentations for. Now, we'll do those first before we get into the serious stuff. First up, during our break, there was an instrumental being played. And this year, the Australian Songwriters Association decided to make a presentation to an instrumental section winner. And they have elected Mr. Don Hillman with a song entitled Joanna. If Don would like to come out, and we've also got Alex Bialocchi from the Australian Songwriters Association to make the presentation.
Thanks very much, Daryl. You know, it's funny, when my partner and I, Gerald, started up Arc Sound some 7 years ago out of our backyard, one of our early clients was a band called the Don Hillman Band. And I never thought that 7 years later that I'd be giving him money back. But congratulations on a fantastic song.
Yeah, I'd just like to say thanks a lot. This is a big thrill for me. Good on the Australian Songwriters Association for putting on a contest like this and encouraging some people to write some music. And I'd like to send a cheerio to Denise on table one. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Don. Congratulations and thanks, Alex. All right, a couple more special presentations. If I can get my pages right here. The next one is for the lyric-only section. And the winner of that, with a song entitled Ruins of Love, is a young lady called Olga Spiropoulos. And to present her award, Mr. Paul O'Gorman.
Thank you, Daryl. I'd just like to say that it's very difficult to find lyric writers, good lyric writers, and I was pleased that with a number of the entries that were in the contest that the standard was good, and I'm very pleased to be able to present this check and certificate to Olga Spiropoulos.
Thank you very much. This is really wonderful. And it's also an incentive to keep writing. Thank you.
Well done, Olga. Thanks, Paul. Yes, very important. Where would Elton John be without Bernie Taupin and Burt Bacharach without Hal David? All those guys. The final category of these special ones is for the novelty section. Now, there was quite a few novelty songs submitted this year, and the judges decided to make our novelty section winner, Mr. Rob Fairburn, and to present his award, Mike Brady.
Thank you.
Oh, shut up, Daryl.
Yes, it's my pleasure to make this presentation to Rob. I've luckily been involved in quite a few novelty songs, or so-called novelty songs in Australia. And Daryl says all my songs are novelty songs, but not just the ones that that I've been involved in as a writer, but also the ones that we've been lucky enough to be involved with as producers. As I just said to Rob backstage a moment ago, the hardest thing with a novelty song, when you have a hit with it, is to follow it up. Don't I know it? Doesn't Jacko know it? Doesn't Joe Dolce know it? But anyway, Rob, it's an honour for me to be able to present you with this. It's a great song. I've heard it. First of all, there's your certificate for tonight, and also your winner envelope, which is $150, as an encouragement to you to go on with it. Ladies and gentlemen, Rob Fairburn, and his song was called, the winning song was called Thongs. Rob Fairburn.
Thank you very much. Thanks very much to Mark and Helmut for encouraging me and adding a few extra verses, and to my wife Judy for putting up with me for so many years. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Rob. Rob, before you go, just before we get onto the serious side of things, which is announcing the finalists in the four categories, how about you do us the honour of a song, just to break the, I don't know if it's monotony, but just a bit of light entertainment before we get into the serious things. Just happens to have his guitar waiting in the wings. Wasn't rehearsed at all, was it? No. Spontaneous. All set to go?
Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rob Fairburn and Thongs.
Thank you. I figured if Billy Connolly could write a song about gumboots, I could write a song about thongs.
Thongs, thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs, from Ayers Rock to Geelong. They're the fair dinkum thing to put on. From the bush to the sea, every Aussie agrees that your feet aren't complete without thongs. Here's a chorus. Thongs, sing along. Thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs. There's Darren Hinch in between songs, makes it up as he's going along. You might think he's sincere as he's bashing your ear, but I bet he wears black Gucci thongs. Thongs, thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs. And there's Alan Border in his thongs. He can feel a 4X coming on. The Aussies were down, but they're coming around, and they can't wait to take on the Poms. Thongs, thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs. Listen, Paul, something's wrong. The Australian bucks have the gong. Oh, come on, Bob, just relax. We'll invent a new tax. A dollar a piece on each thong. Thongs, thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs. And there's more way out west. Alan Bond wants to keep the cup where it belongs. He's yet to reveal the new shape of his keel, but I bet it looks just like a thong. Thongs, thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet can't be wrong.
Everyone's wearing them bong.
Now, Mr. Wong, some damn monkey has stolen my thongs.
Oh, what kind were they, sir? Oh, Dunlops for sure. Oh, they have a branch here in Hong Kong.
Thong, thong, everybody lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet, can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs. One more time. Thongs, thongs, lift up your voices in song. 29 million feet, can't be wrong. Everyone's wearing them thongs, 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 thongs.
Thank you.
Terrific, wasn't it? Well done, Rob. Thank you. Right, that got everyone in the right frame of mind. Okay, now the big announcements, the final announcements for our winners. And first of all, the category is our pop category. First one tonight. And we're going to ask a lady who was actually one of the preliminary judges. We spoke earlier about all the songs that were submitted initially, and then we got down to the final 12. And Hillary Quinn from Mushroom Records was one of the preliminary judges, and we're going to ask Hillary to come out now and join me and to announce the winner in the pop category.
Is that right?
Yep. This has been by no means an easy task. We've picked the 3 finalists out of the 80 contestants, and the winner is... Sorry. The winner is Remember by...
Scott Robin, music and lyrics. Congratulations, Scott. Well done. Would you like to...
Yeah. Here we go. The worst part, actually.
Yeah. A few words. Thanks.
Thanks mostly to the songwriting competition in itself, which has given us a chance to do it, which is excellent. My mum and dad, Sue and Simon, brothers, friends from the hospital in the back there. Thanks, guys. Everyone, my nan. Thank you. It's just great. Thanks very much.
Well done. Yes, great song. And well done too to our other 2 songs in that category. Be a big night in Williamstown tonight. All right, where am I? Country music. And I'm going to ask Mike Brady to come out once again and announce the winner of our country music category. And as he's coming out, I'll just remind you that the songs were It's About Time, lyrics and music by Cash Backman, The Gambler and the Lady, lyrics by Marie Murphy and Dominic Cree, and I'm Lost for Words by Paul Wilson, music by Les Gock. Mike, want to join us?
Just before I announce this, I'd just like to say one little thing. Being a songwriter, and I've been a songwriter for a few years, I am really thrilled to be here tonight because in Australia, we really do need all the encouragement we can get. People have been bashing their heads up against the wall because of our small market here. And it's organisations like this that'll really help. It'll create a forum for Australian writers. And it's well worth a round of applause. Right, the winner, without further ado, in the country category, as voted by the judges, is I'm Lost for Words, lyrics by Paul Wilson, music by Les Gock.
Could Anna come down and collect the award, please?
To present the award on behalf of Paul Wilson and Les Gock, is Anna, and they're not here tonight, and I'd like you to accept this with our congratulations, this $250 cash award on their behalf, please. Ladies and gentlemen, Anna, great performance too.
Well, just on behalf of Paul Wilson and Liz Gok, I'd like to say thank you very much. I've never met the guys, and I hope I did their song justice. I think it must have, if they won this. So, thank you.
Thanks, Anna. Thanks, Mike. Thanks, Anna. Gee, that's interesting. She's never met them. Hope they give you a share of the check. All right, we're going to move along now to our middle of the road, or MOR category, and get my old mate Paul O'Gorman out here again to help me with this one. Paul? And just as he's coming out, I'll just recap those songs. The Last Tear, lyrics and music by Stu Storm, performed by Stu Storm. Pain is the Price Paid, lyrics and music by Russell Beggs. And finally, Any Stronger Now, lyrics and music by Rob Stambulic.
Stambulic.
Thank you. This was a tough category for us all. But we've finally decided the judge's decision, the winner of the middle of the road category, is Any Stronger Now, Rob Stambulic. On behalf of the judges, Rob, congratulations. Great song and good luck for the future. Okay.
Bravo. I'd like to thank, first of all, Angela for singing the song. That's Angela's table and my table over there. And I'd like to thank the people for putting this on so I could win $250 and pay Frank Racina back some money. And also, to thank the people on table 28 or 29 or 27, I'm not sure which one it is, but they're the ones who made all the noise when it was announced. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Rob. Okay, a few more to go. We've got our final category, which is the rock category, and then of course the Eon FM Encouragement Award, as well as the overall winner for the best song of the night. So for the next one, which is our rock category, if I can just find my place here, we'd like to call out Pat Rosen, who is the director of Action Music, and Pat's going to come out and present the rock category winner, please. I'll just recap those for you if you like too. No, stay here, you're right. I better do that. Suicide was the first one, and that's lyrics and music by Norman Flavo. Did I get that right? Oh, that's right. They changed it on everything except the program. Falvo. Sorry, Norman. The second song was Lover Lover, lyrics by David Seddon, music by Debbie Bignall, and also final song, Beyond the Moon, lyrics and music by David Minchin. Over to you.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the Australian Songwriters Association, I'd just like to say that this has been the best sort of performance of acts tonight, and Dominic, right down to all the people involved, have done a fantastic job, and I think that everybody involved, I'm sure you enjoyed yourself tonight. And I'd just like to say the winner of the rock category, which wasn't easy, is Lover Lover, lyrics by David Seddon, music by Debbie Bignall.
Have we got some? Have we got someone that'd like to come down and have his check, or I'll keep it? Here they come. David and Debbie are on the way, yes. I was going to say, Pat, you got a great shirt on, mate. Looks good. Would one of you like to just say a thank you? Yes.
Well, I'd just like to thank everyone for attending here, and I'd like to thank my co-partner with who I really couldn't have achieved this, and that's Debbie Bignall. Debbie and I have worked on a lot of songs together, and I write the lyric, but I think the main part of this the song coming together relies a lot on the person who puts the music together. And I've got to thank Debbie. I've worked with Debbie, and I find that we have a great partnership. I want to thank Songwriters, and I want to thank a couple of people in particular. That's Carmen and Endel Saralat for their support, and John and Marie Murphy, and everyone who's here tonight. I thank you for coming, and thanks for the nominations.
I just like everything that Dave said, I agree with, and he writes really good lyrics and they're easy to work with, which is the main thing. And I'd just like to thank everyone for coming along, and I hope you've enjoyed the evening. The music is really good, and all the other people in the category with me, I'd just like to thank them for entering, because it was really tough and I got a surprise and I got lost on the way up too. And hello to table 25 and a half. Goodbye.
Congratulations to Debbie and David, the winner of our rock category. All right, a couple more to go. And for this one, this is one that throughout the song competition, entries were invited from all over the country, and you didn't have to actually be a member of the Australian Songwriters Association. But this particular award, which is the Encouragement Award from Eon FM, is restricted to members only of the Australian Songwriters Association. And to present that award, I'd like to introduce you to Lee Simon.
Thank you, Daryl. It was very good to see Debbie Bignall and her partner win the last award. Debbie was responsible, really, for the first Eon FM Encouragement Award, as it was 3 years ago in South Yarra, actually, somewhere in... What was that horrible place? I better not mention the place, but it certainly was nothing like the Palace. But Debbie really impressed the judges and sort of inspired me to, on behalf of Eon FM, pledge a certain amount of money, which I had to sort of rapidly justify the following Monday morning. However, the award has continued over the last couple of years, and it's doubled this year. And it always is very difficult as a judge when you're not only involved in assessing what you think of particular songs, but also to try and work out who you believe is meant to end up at the end of the night with a bit of encouragement in the form of a cheque for $500. The one that we've decided for tonight goes to somebody who I thought was slightly misplaced in the category, in the middle of the road category, Stu Storm. What I've got here is a check made out to your name, so I hope that is your real name. Otherwise, the bank manager is going to give you a slightly hard time in trying to cash it. That's cool. Deed poll. If we got Savas, maybe you've got a title change coming up here. Congratulations, Stu. All the very best, and I hope you really grow with it.
What can I say? Thanks to Eon, and I just wish you guys had it got onto the domino theory in the first place. Oh. Eh? Sorry, Lee. Oh, spiteful. I'd just like to thank Alison. Thank you.
Stu, don't go away. Stu, Don't go away. Hello? Earth to Moon? Stu, if we could... this is actually a two-part award, and the perpetual Rudy Bransma Memorial Trophy is also part of your prize as part of the Encouragement Award. And we're going to call out last year's winner, which is Steve Wade. Steve, if you'd like to come out and join us. Steve really scooped the pool last year. I think if anyone was here last year, they'll remember. How you doing? Nice to see you again. Stu, if you want to just come over here, and Steve's got a presentation for you.
Another speech. A quick one. Okay. A quick one. What can I say? I'd just like to thank God. And I mean that seriously and sincerely, eh? And I'd like to thank my mother and father as well, and to all my family for attending tonight, and I love you all.
Thanks very much, Stu. Congratulations. Well done. And thank you to Steve. All right. Now, where am I? The overall winner, which is the overall winner for tonight on all the songs that you've seen performed. And to present that one, well-known identity in the music field, been involved as a songwriter himself and then just in all facets of the music business, would you welcome Ron Lee?
What's in a song? That was the name of a presentation that I gave to some 30 or 40 members of the Songwriters Association earlier this year. And in that presentation, I said that some of the ingredients of a good song were inspiration, perspiration, motivation, and dedication. And I'm sure that for the songwriters that you've heard tonight, they would all agree that they've gone through those facets or those ingredients of songwriting in reaching where they have tonight. And I would like to congratulate all of the individual winners. What do you say to the other 400 odd entrants in the songwriting competition? All I can say is press on, keep going. That if you've heard the entrance tonight, and a thought has crossed your mind about working on polishing up your lyric writing or developing a better sense of melody or working to become more in tune with the market, well, you've got a winning attitude and you'll go on to better things. Because to be up here receiving the award for writing a first-class song, you really need to adapt an attitude of constructive discontent with your present abilities. And then if you work on those and you work on that desire to be better and you work towards being the best that you can be, you'll be up here. And to everyone, I can only say, become more involved in the Australian Songwriters Association, because that attitude of being the best that you can has worked through from the committee, through a number of songwriters that I've met in the times that I've been involved with them, all the way down. And that's the result of that is the increased membership and the real action that's happening through the club, which is really exciting to see. It's great to walk in tonight and see so many people who are involved and interested in songwriting. This wouldn't have happened years ago. It's really exciting. As a close observer of this enthusiastic movement, I can only say that the original founder of the movement, Rudy Bransma, would be excited to see that the spirit in which he founded or co-founded work with people has been preserved through the years. That is an unselfish giving and helping one another. And that's great to see. And it can only be encouraged. And so I thank and congratulate the Australian Songwriters Association on holding such a marvellous competition. I congratulate all the winners and hope that 1987 will be even better. Now, as I said in my talk, that the ingredients of a good song are motivation, perspiration, dedication, and inspiration. And hopefully, if you've got the right balance of that, along with a real ability and a real talent, you come out the overall winner, and you end up with a standing ovation. So help me welcome and present the overall winner tonight for the song Any Stronger Now Rob Stambulik. It's my pleasure to present you with this check for $500 as being the overall winner tonight in the Australian Songwriter Association competition. I hope it helps you to go on to bigger and better things. I look forward to hearing your songs on the radio soon. Congratulations.
Thank you. I hope there's someone out there who can realise what Mr. Ron Lee just said and put the songs on the radio so we can all get a little bit more money. Thank you very much.
Don't go away, we've got a couple of other things. No? He's not listening to me. Rob, can you come up again? Where's he gone? No, you're not going to sing it. Actually, we might see if we can get Angela to come up and perform it in a second. So, Angela, if you want to make your way up here, we might persuade her to do that. There are a couple of little surprise things to add on to tonight's for our winners. And I think one of them involves a gentleman called John Van Boxtel. And John's going to come out and he's got another presentation to make to you.
Very quiet start, hey. Rob and Angela, congratulations on our part. Where is Angela? Angela, you out there? We can only see one white light out here, so Angela, if you're out there, come up here, please. On behalf of Ram Studios, we'd just like to present you with 20 hours of free recording time, all right? That includes tape costs and engineer as well. We'd like to see you get into 87 with a big kick, all right? And just while Angela is trying to find a way up here, I hope. Rob's all nervous about this one. I'd just like to thank Dominic for putting on such a great show up here. And his committee as well. Come on, folks. Let's hear for Dominic. I think they've done an excellent job. He was so nervous before he couldn't even find a microphone. And I hope his missus doesn't allow him to think about that later on. We haven't found Angela yet, huh? She's in the back. Angela, would you like to come up? Is she out there? I can give you a plug about Ram Studios if I want.
Actually, John, well, before we get Angela out here, there's one final thing. And speaking of Dominic, we'll get Dominic to come out. Dominic, would you come out and make one more announcement? Yep. We'll fix up the recording business in a minute.
Okay. Alex Graham, partner. Alex Wilocki, the Vice President of the Australian Songwriters Association. Give him a hand.
Thank you.
Before we get Angela to perform the song again, we've got a couple of surprises, actually. I'd like to call upon the runner-up in each category, and that's Callum Hammond. Please come up to the stage. David Gillard, Cash Backman, Marie Murphy, Russell Beggs, Norman Falvo and David Mitchum. Would you please all come up to the stage? Because of the tremendous support we've had from our sponsors, we're able to give all the runner-ups a $100 check, okay, which is about $800 or something, which is fantastic. Alex, if you'd like to do the honours. Okay, well, while all this is happening in the background, there's a couple more surprises. Because we've had so many entries compared to last year, we've decided that we will actually print a certificate of achievement which will be given to all songwriters that came close to getting to their songs into the finals. It's a bit hard when you think about it, you know, 420 songs or something, and trying to break that down to 12 finalists. There's obviously a lot of good songs that just missed out. And so the association has printed a certificate of achievement, and we will actually mail that out to the people concerned, all the songwriters concerned. It's all based on the way the judges did their scores, okay? So if, for instance, the top song got 100 points, 100 out of 100, and I don't know, song number 5 that didn't make it got 85, that'll get a certificate of achievement. So that's really cool. All right. I might be in it. At this point in time, I'd also like to thank the judges for the night, Lee Simon, Mike Brady, Paul O'Gorman, and Patrick Roseanne. They did a fantastic job. To the committee, Noreen Kane, Gary Withers, and Alex Bylocki. It couldn't have been done without you guys. Fantastic. There's two very special ladies within the committee, if you like. They're not really officially in there anywhere, but they work behind the scenes throughout the year. And one lady is Janine Withers. And a lady that I know very well, very intimately actually, my wife Diane Creer. Fantastic. And I shouldn't forget my employees who were very sympathetic to the Australian Songwriters Association. I work there part-time now. I don't know how they put up with me, actually. All the photostatting that I do, all the phone calls, but it's really, really great. I'd like to thank Record and Coleman Foods also. Thank you. Daryl?
Yeah.
Can you announce it? Thank you.
Thanks, Dominic. Thanks very much to everybody. I think only fitting that we get our overall winner to perform again. And ladies and gentlemen, would you put your hands together for Angela Bazoulis, performing our overall song winner, Any Stronger Now.
Does it feel any stronger now?
king in my home, in my heart, heart again. He's been thinking a long time, I don't know if I should let this go on. He knew that never imagined letting go. Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now? Now, now again, he's been thinking a long time. I don't know if I should let this go on. He knew that never imagined letting go. Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now? Does it feel any stronger now?
Thank you.
Thanks, Angela. Well done. What about a hand for the band as well? They've done a terrific job tonight. Thanks, fellas. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Thank you very much for your support. We hope you've had a good time. You're welcome to stay on for the rest of the evening. I think they kick you out about 1 o'clock or something, so you're welcome to do that. Thanks once again for coming along, and take it easy on the way home. Good night. See you on the Early Bird Show.
Tony were able to take home with them for 12 months a special trophy which means a very great deal to us members of the association. The trophy was called the Rudy Bransma Memorial Trophy. And to explain for you exactly what that is, because it does have great significance to us, only a few short years ago the Songwriters Association commenced. With very humble beginnings, I might say. The leader of the association in those days was a very popular musician. His name was Rudy Bransma. And he offered a great deal of guidance and help to all of the new members at that stage. Unfortunately, about 2 years ago, very sadly, Rudy passed away. And to honour him for future competitions and for the life of the association, a perpetual trophy was formed, which would be handed to each winner, the overall winner of every contest from then on, and it would be kept for 12 months, after which it would be brought back and returned to the stage to be presented to the winner of, in this case, tonight's competition. Now, as I said, Debbie Bignell and Tony Stark were the winners, or the writing winners, of the song that won last year. Debbie and Tony are here tonight with the trophy. I'd like you to welcome them on stage, please. I'd like now to for the evening, who I'm sure you'll all recognise because he is a well-known recording artist in his own right. In fact, he is extremely well-known in the multimedia of this city and in fact Australia. He's been extremely sympathetic to the cause of the Songwriters Association for the years that it's been running. He's been very helpful in everything we've asked him to do for us. In fact, he's a proven songwriter in his own right. He's been very successful. At the moment, he's the compere of the Channel 10 Early Bird Show. I'd like you to please make him welcome now, Daryl.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. Thanks, Russell. Where did you get all that information from?
Daryl.
Yes. You do? I'd like to say thank you for inviting me on tonight to be part of the contest.
Thank you,
Daryl. It says on my rundown we're to talk about the palace. Have you got anything you'd like to say about the palace?
Well, it's the first time I've been here, Daryl.
Likewise, I don't get out much these days.
I am thoroughly interested.
Actually, it's terrific. Yes. Nice. That's enough, Russell. Thanks, man. All right. Thanks, Russell. Yes, I'd once again like to welcome you all along, and haven't done anything like this for quite a while, and feel a bit strange without my sidekick, Marnie Monster, up here with me, but we'll carry on regardless. We hope you're going to have a good time. From looking at the program, I'm sure you're aware there's four categories tonight: the pop, rock, MOR, middle of the road, and of course, what's the other one? Country. There it is, yes. So you'll be seeing three songs from each category performed, and have a little browse through your program. There's prizes for each particular category. There's also a prize, a $250 encouragement award, courtesy of Eon FM, which I think is terrific. And also there is a grand prize for the best song of the evening. So I'd like to, what do I have to do? Oh, of course, the most important part, the judges. I must, would like to introduce to you, first of all, our judges who are going to be watching pretty carefully. A lot of song competitions don't actually take into consideration the actual performance of the song, and this is something the judges will be watching tonight. Some of the writers are performing their own songs, and as well as that, others have nominated people to hopefully do a good job of their songs. That's why I wasn't asked to sing a song, obviously. Anyway, I will introduce the judges to you, and not in any order of importance or anything. I hope no one upstairs gets offended. But first of all, a guy that I've known for a little while, and a former customer of mine actually, when I had a flower shop. The program manager of the very successful Eon FM, Mr. Lee Simon. From radio station 3PBS, a lady who I understand has done a lot, believe me, quite a lot of encouraging new talent right around the country, Helen Meyer. This next judge happens to be a close personal friend, made a couple of appearances on the Early Bird Show, a former Countdown Best New Talent Award winner. Actually knocked me out. I was in the running too, and he came first and I came second. Back in, when was it, Paul? 1978? Yeah. Was? Yeah. Anyway, Paul O'Gorman, everyone. Paul's actually a songwriter of note, and in fact has represented Australia, I believe, back a few years ago at the Tokyo Song Festival with one of his own compositions, so he certainly knows what he's talking about, and in fact now looks after the publishing for the Fable Image Publishing Company. Next up, one of the country's best and most popular country performers. The guy's had a number of hits, including My Girl Bill, back a few years ago. Would you welcome Cash Backman? And last but not least, a guy whose work I admire a great deal. In fact, my wife saw him the other night and told him that she enjoys his work too. A composer who laughed. A composer, a jingle writer, a man that's been responsible for some terrific music scores for films like Man from Snowy River and of course Farlap, Mr. Bruce Rollins.
Bruce, I
Billy, he came out of his sick bed tonight too, so we appreciate you making the effort. Hopefully he can hang in there for the 12 songs. All right, that's our judges, and I think we should get the evening underway. We're going to start out with a pop category, and first up is a song entitled I'm Burning. The composer, words and music, is a young lady called Rayma Lane. I'd like you to make her welcome with I'm Burning.
Thank you.
Rayma Lane, everybody. next up, the second song in the pop category is a song written by Jeff Wells and Neil Moore. The song is entitled Maybe, and is performed by Jeff Wells. Jeff Wells, everybody. Song
written by Callum Hammond, words and music, and also performed by Callum. It's a song entitled Modern Love.
Ad-lib with writer. So how's your ad-lib, all right?
It's not bad with that.
What sort of influences on your songwriting would you say? What sort of artists?
Well, try quite a bit on guitar and influence, depends on the music at the time.
But yeah, modern era. Any sort of performers that you particularly admire? Or
Simple Minds.
Oh yeah, right.
That's
I remember them. Don't play them much in Canada, would you? Well, anyway, mate, good luck. And congratulations for coming this far.
Thanks very much.
All right. Callum, everybody. First up is a song by a guy who has been around a little while and seems to be doing quite well. His name's Keith Glass. He's the composer, the lyricist, words of music, and the performer. And the song is, hang on, can't even read my own writing, How Many More Moves? Keith Glass.
Thank you.
category, and I must add that once again there's $250 for the winning song out of the three. The winning song receives $250 for this category. This next one could be nothing more than a country song with a title like this, Cadillac Jack. The lyrics are by Ross Nicholson and John Coco, lyrics and music, and it's performed tonight by Ross Nicholson. Ross, everybody, Cadillac Jack.
Within his mind, they'd be there and done that. What a hard day. If I'm still
relate to the composer on stage, and that's Marie Murphy. Marie, can you join us? Firstly, I apologise for calling you Mary. I should know better. I work with a Murray every week. Anyway, here's your certificate, your final certificate. Congratulations. And shall I ask you a question? No? Just one. Have you got many songs? Do you write many songs?
A few.
A few. All right. That's your question.
Thank you.
Okay? Thanks, Murray. And Jane. And at this part of the evening, they've asked me to introduce the guys behind that are working so hard. And I don't know where I should start. My old mate Graham, I guess. Graham Morgan on drums, everybody. Everything okay, mate? No complaints? Nothing you want? Nothing special? A refill? We'll get you a refill in a little while. Also on bass, Tony Mazziotto. It's happy birthday, Daryl. Is it? It is his birthday. Oh, well, happy birthday. No songs. John, please forgive me. LaCorsia? John LaCorsia? On guitar, John LaCorsia. Who so much is the Oliver chap. Good on you, John. You're bringing your up royal. On keyboards, we've got Roger Montgomery and Jeff Wood. And of course our conductor, MD, whatever you like, Greg Ellis, everybody. And of course we can't go on without mentioning our sound man, Bill Tullock from Arc Music. Thanks, Bill, for your help. All right, we move now to the middle of the road category. And once again, three songs and $250 for the winning song. The first song is entitled Ocean Deep by a guy who you're going to see a couple of times tonight. He's actually submitted a few songs that have been judged and put through into the finals. Anyway, the song is Ocean Deep, words and music by Steve Wade and performed by Steve Wade. Steve Wade.
Thank you.
songwriter and also a hand for Paul Cartwell. Paul was helping Steve on backing vocals. I believe you're both the guys in here. Yeah, maybe, hang on, I'm gonna. Right, you're both in a band together.
Yeah.
Dolphin Strip?
That's right.
I got it right?
That's right.
Mate, I just wondered, a song like that, how long would a song like that take you to write? I saw on the rundown that you've got a couple more songs in the contest.
Yeah,
one like that, how long would that take?
Hard to say, I don't know. Sometimes 20 minutes, sometimes...
20 days.
Sometimes yeah. 2 years.
Well, listen, congratulations. Here's your final certificate. We want you to stay around because you're going to, I believe, perform the next song. It's a song called Heart on My Sleeve. Song number two, and the words and music are by Paul Hillman, but performed by Steve White. Here's Steve once more. How's everyone doing? All right? You're all okay? She wants a photo. Oh, want it mounted or? Yeah. All right, we'll fix that later. We have a little hiccup, as I said. We've lost the next performer. Rob Forza hasn't fronted. So what we're going to have to do, judges, if you could make note, is hang on to this next song, which is Don't Forget by Daryl McKenzie. And hopefully, if the performer Rob turns up before the end of the evening, we'll get him up to do it at the end of the songs. All right, so that's our middle of the road category, and now we move on to the rock category. Keep it down under there. All right, into the rock category, and once again, three songs. And first of all, song number 10, well, in actual fact, it's song number 9 at the moment. The song is entitled Into the Twilight, lyrics and music by Debbie Bignell. Is Melinda ready? She probably didn't realise we were going to cut that short. She's right. You guys have got the right chart up. You're not going to play a middle of the road song, are you? No? All right, ladies and gentlemen, the song is Into the Twilight, performed by Melinda Cerasoli. Cerasoli. There's a misprint. It's a C, sorry. Wasn't me. That's right, just the way I pronounce it. Apologies. Where's Sandy Robbins? All right, there we go.
I'm
Debbie Bignell, who is the composer of the song. Good evening, Debbie. How are you? Debbie is actually our winner from last year.
That's right.
That's right. Congratulations for submitting. You got a lot of songs in your repertoire?
Yes, as many as you.
That isn't a great deal, you know, Debbie.
A bit more.
A bit more than me. Here's your, got your hand out there, all right. There's your final certificate. And we'll see what the judges have to say about your song a little bit later on. Okay, thanks, girls. Debbie Bignell and Melinda Gerasol. Okay, next up is the second song in our rock category, and familiar face. Lyrics and music by Steve Wade, performed once again by Steve, and the song is entitled Shadow of Love. He's here.
Take it or leave it, everybody.
Well, guess what, Steve? Another certificate. Congratulations, mate. You've done very well. What can I ask you that's intelligent? How long have you been writing songs?
10 years.
Can't you elaborate on that? How many months and days?
Sorry.
Now, you've done a terrific job. Congratulations and good luck with the contest tonight. All right?
Thanks.
Steve, wait a minute. Hang on, I've got to know you. Don't forget. Let me see. Oh, no, we haven't. That's going to be the next thing I said. Actually, no, I've got to ask for Daryl McKenzie to come up on stage. Daryl is our third writer in the middle of the road category, but unfortunately our performer hasn't turned up. Daryl, could you come up on stage and join me? There he is. What can I say, mate? You should have given me a call. Listen, congratulations for making the finals. I'm sorry that we weren't able to hear the song. I can't imagine what's happened to Rob. Yeah, I hope it's something like that. Yes. Anyway, congratulations for making the finals. I really appreciate all that work to come this far and then have something like that happen. Wouldn't be. Lisa, you would never hope if I said no. Never mind. Anyway, that's the songs for this evening, and what we're now going to do, it says on my rundown, is having about a 20-minute break, 20 minutes to half an hour, while the judges get together and talk about the songs. It also says that the committee, it says committee member to ensure that the judges are served with supper. So they get the feature, all right? So don't go out there. They got dim sims and the whole lot, I think. No, they got something. So have a 20-minute break, and we'll be back with some of the results.
Thoughts of life with you were so hard to understand. Somehow, somewhere, I've had something along the way. Now all I want is some way to make you stay. Don't forget. Thank you.
excuse. My excuse is I was filming with the ABC until 20 past 8, out of Worcester Field. There's a new children's television show called Trap Whipped on a Box. It's only taken a minute.
That's all right.
So for all of those out there that watch television on the ABC from about 10 o'clock onwards, it's on Thursdays and Fridays starting early March. So it's called Trap Whipped on a Box. It's fantastic. Thank you. Rob, have you heard of the early bird chat? All right, listen, that's our songs, and we'll let you get on with the evening, and we'll let the judges get down to some serious judging. We'll be back in a little while. Thanks very much. It really isn't that easy to get a break in the business anymore. Not like when I was a kid. And anything like this is a terrific sort of showcase for songwriters and performers. Anyway, we'll get down to business now, and starting with our pop category. I'll just quickly recap those songs for you. See you somewhere. Pop category. First song was I'm Burning. Lyrics and music by Ray Malane. Sounds a bit like Ray Maland. Sorry, Ray. Song number two was Maybe by Jeff Wells. Music by Jeff Wells and Neil Moore. And the third song was Modern Love. Lyrics and music by Callum Hammond. And to present that award, this award, I'd like to get my old mate Paul O'Gorman out on stage. Good to see you, mate.
Yeah.
You can have your own mic if you like.
That's great.
No expense spared tonight.
Thank you.
Well, what do you think?
Great. The judges were all very impressed with the standard and songs and
you always say that. Tonight.
We always say that, but we really mean it tonight. And I'm here to present the prize for the best song in the pop category. And I'm pleased to say the song is I'm Burning, and the singer and writer is Ray Marlane.
Few friends on the way.
Give her a big round of applause.
Congratulations, Ray. You can do the dirty deed. You can give her the money.
Here is your check. $250 and a certificate in blank. We promise it will be filled out for you a little later. So there you go.
Is there anything you'd like to say?
I'd just like to say thank you to everybody for coming. And here's our smile for you, I'm happy to know. I'd like to thank the sponsors and particularly this association for having such a great sort of organisation whereby people that write their own original material can be fully exploited in the best way possible. Thank you very much to everybody.
Thanks, Ray. Congratulations. Thank you, Paul. Okay, we move on to the country category. The song Once More for you, or How Many More Moves? Lyrics and music by Keith Glass, performed by Keith Glass. Cadillac Jack, lyrics by Ross Nicholson, music by Ross Nicholson and John Coco, and performed by Ross Nicholson. And, finally, nearly missed out, Rainbow Chaser, lyrics and music by Marie Murphy, and performed by Jane Maddock. These are our three songs. And to help me with the presentation, Cash Backman, everyone.
Play a hotel!
It's a good looking bloke.
What's that?
Play a hotel!
Play a hotel, nothing. I know who you are, I saw you from the balcony before. I'm not even looking that way. I think with the country music song, I'm very proud and privileged to be a judge involved with country music, and it's a sort of category that's pretty close to my heart. And I was really excited to see a guy performing here tonight that that I can't say that I had the pleasure to work with, but I did work with him about 13 odd years ago. We were both at Rose Music. And the reason I mention that is because, and I want to say this, it was unanimous. This was an absolutely unanimous decision. And I'm very proud to say that the winner in the country music section was Ross Diggins. This song was pitched at me on recording.
There we go. Congratulations. Where's John? Is he going to come up?
John?
I think we should get John up. Just to...
Come on, John. Get your check, man. It's all yours. This won't take long, but...
Talk about an entrance. Congratulations, John.
At least he wasn't as late as somebody else was tonight.
All right. I guess that's what we do is hand a check over the certificate.
Thanks very much. Everybody involved with this. I can't really do much better than Raymond did earlier. I just think it's great that everybody gets a chance to get some recognition for a lot of hard work, which songwriting is, believe it or not. Thanks very much, everybody.
Thanks, Ross. Thanks, John. Thanks, Dave. That's our country song award, and we move on to the middle of the road. And the songs, just recapping for you, Ocean Deep, lyrics and music by Steve Wade, performed by Steve Wade, Heart on My Sleeve, lyrics and music by Paul Hillman, performed by Steve Wade, and Don't Forget, lyrics and music by Daryl McKenzie, performed by Robert Forza, and also backing vocal by Russell Zimmer. Again, Russell. And to announce that award, Bruce Rollins, would you make Bruce welcome. How are you feeling?
I think I've got a stand
by. You have? I've got a gun out the back of the show.
Excuse my voice, I've got the stand by as well as a really good song. We were amazed actually at the quality of the Middle of the Road category. It was really fantastic as far as the three songs. But we had a unanimous winner, and I think it's an excellent song. And it's Steve Wade for us.
It's been a great night, and I'd also like to especially thank Paul Carswell for his help in the vocals.
Thanks very much.
Thanks, Bruce.
Moving right along, the rock category. Have I missed anything? No, you're right. The rock category, and the songs Into the Twilight, lyrics and music by Debbie Bignell, and performed by Melinda Gerasoli. Got it right in my mind. Yes. Shadow of Love, lyrics and music by Steve Wade, performed by Steve Wade. And finally, Take It or Leave It, lyrics and music by Stephen Wade, and performed by Stephen once again. And to help me out with this one, I'd like you to welcome from 3PBS, Helen Meyer.
Helen, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. It's a great pleasure to present this award because rock is something that's very close to my heart. And I guess there's certain ingredients that we look for when choosing a rock song, and probably the most important things are feel and passion and a kind of power that makes you want to sit up and listen and, more importantly, get up and dance. And the song that did that tonight was Take It or Leave It. Yeah!
It's all been said. Congratulations, Steve. I'll hit you for a line after. Okay. Thanks, Helen. Thank you very much. Steve Wade. Terrific future, I think, for Steve. We move on now, as the program says, to the Encouragement Award. And also included in this is the Rudy Bransma Memorial Trophy. And I'm going to get Lee Simon out there to give me a hand with that one. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome from me on your hand with Lee Simon.
Thanks a lot.
Hello,
how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, as Daryl just said, there are two awards here. One is cash, and the other one, of course, is the Rudy Bransma Award, which has been won over the last couple of years by Debbie Bignall, who's done so much work with the association and also has embellished the writing skills over the years as well. A very difficult decision to make, the Encouragement Award. I mean, an awards night such as this, I think, offers encouragement to everybody who not only enters, but also the finalists and obviously the ultimate winners for the night. I think, however, there has been somebody who, by his very recurrence on stage, has indicated that there is some more encouragement required to help him along the way. So the Eon FM Encouragement Award this year in the 1985 Australian Association of Songwriters, or Australian Songwriters Association Awards, and also the Rudy Bransma Award goes tonight to Steve Wade.
Jim is Vice President?
Yeah.
He's officially Vice President of the Australian Songwriters Association. He's really worked very hard in putting tonight together. I think you've done a terrific job, man.
Thank you. I had a lot of good luck tonight. But Russell will be on later to explain all that. I've just come here to give Daryl the check for the most important prize tonight. And Daryl's going to...
Is this mine?
Yeah.
Oh, we've got to get it.
Yours is... Your four are outside.
Mine's in the mail. Is it all right?
Okay, Daryl will take over again because he's doing such a great job. What do you think?
Okay, well, it's the best overall song, and I'm really not quite sure how the judges came to this decision. I'm sure it was a hard one because of the different categories. It's hard to compare a country song with a rock song, and you know, vice versa, the middle of the road with a pop song. But I've had a word to them all, and I understand the winner of the... Hang on, keep me in suspense. The best overall song, I really know, but I'm just kind of, you know, messing around here. The song is Cadillac Jack. Yeah! Lyrics Rusty. Music by Ross Nicholson and John Coco. Where are the guys?
Thank you.
Well, I've got another check for you, so there we go, boys. Do with it. Another, gee, you're a pretty generous guy. I'd like to write songs with you.
No, I've got to pay for the time that I do for the demos.
Oh, I see. Right. Well, listen, congratulations, guys.
Thanks very much.
Well deserved. And,
well, Steve said it all. I'm absolutely flabbergasted too. I would like to thank the judges heaps.
Ladies
and the band.
Yes, the guys in the band. Yes, what about a hand for the boys in the band? Thanks very much, fellas. And yes, thank you to our judges. And I think we're going to get. Did you want to play them off or something? Oh, we're going to get the guys to sing, of course. Hang on, I wasn't reading my rundown too well. We'll just have a look and see. I'll make sure I've. I think I've just about done my bit for the night. I'd like to say thank you for putting up with me. And having at the early bird show, Saturday morning, 7 but we trust you've had a good time, and we're going to get the boys out to perform the song and Cadillac Jack. And I think that's about it for the night, all right? So we hope you've had a good time, and we'll get the guys out for one more. All right, what about a hand for the boys?
I guess it's easy to come along here this evening and watch all the proceedings and enjoy them in one quick evening, I guess. You wouldn't believe the hard work that goes in to make it happen, and I've got really to thank a few people, because without them, we wouldn't be here. And first of all, I'd like to thank our MC for the night, Daryl Cullen. Of course, those that attended last year's venue will remember the difference between where we are now to where we were then. It hasn't happened for nothing, and we have to remember our sponsors. Without the sponsors, we'd be in dire straits indeed. They've been very, very supportive of the whole association, and I urge you to support them in turn. But let's remember them now. APRA, which is the Australasian Performing Rights Association. ARC Music, who's provided the whole public address sound system for tonight. Eon FM, of course. Amazing Guitars. Music Business Magazine. Ronnelly's Music Factory. And at this point, I'd like to just pause and explain to you that Ron, of course, has been the godfather of the association over the years. He's a very popular personality in the music business in Melbourne. And if you can imagine the one thing that would stop Ron coming tonight, I can't really think what it is, except that Ron is not very well tonight. So he apologises to all of you that he couldn't come, and he's very, very sorry that he's missed it. So Ronnelly's Music Factory is definitely one of the sponsors. Showbiz College at the Brand Tate. Victorian Audio Education Centre in Richmond. The Worldwide Register of Copyrights. The sponsors have all been noted there and have done a fabulous job supporting us. So we thank you all very much. Let's have a round of applause. It's been our pleasure to have the finest band of musicians we've ever assembled. So please, once more for the band. And not forgetting our sound engineer, Bill Tulloch. Now we've mentioned the band. The band have done an excellent job playing the music. You can imagine what it's like trying to arrange all of the music sheets, the charts, from the demo tapes that are sent in. Some are great, some are not so great. It's an enormous challenge, and it takes weeks. The gentleman who has been involved with that totally has gone way beyond the call of duty and offered to conduct the entire operation tonight from a musical standpoint. Ladies and gentlemen, musical director tonight, Greg Ellis. The people that get the magazine organised, all of those little things, all done voluntarily, you must remember, they organise everything that makes this operation here tonight come together over a long period of months in their own time. So lots of running around in the car, millions of telephone calls. We wouldn't be here, in fact, if it were not for Gary Withers and his wife, to be Janine Gow, and Dominic Craig and his wife, Diane. Over the past 12 months, if you are a member, and if you have been coming to the workshops and the various venues that we've been arranging for the Songwriters, I'm sure you'll be aware of the high standard of the workshops that we have been running. The person that's been liaising all of those, it's been quite a large job, he's managed it very well, and has been very instrumental in making sure that we were able to be in this venue tonight, in fact. It's taken a lot of organising on his part, he's done a very good job. Jim Shamos. Now is actually call all of the entrants, the people that have written the songs that have been placed in the finals here tonight, there are 12 of them, if they would all come to the stage please, and we'll have the judges, if they would too, to the stage please. See you all up here please. coming. It's quite an assemblage. We all here, I think so. We are indeed. These are the people that have, firstly, the entrants, which of course have been selected as finalists from about 146 entries, and of course the judges who have judged us so fairly tonight. I think they deserve another round. Appreciate this great venue. That's the first time I've been here. I hope to be back again. I hope you will all come back again. The organisers and the people that have managed to make it all run so smoothly, let's thank them, please. So we close the competition tonight. Thank you all very much for your attendance. But don't go away, because we're rocking on with the disco, the house disco, until the early hours. So thanks very much. Is it in here or in there? That's a good question. Jim? He's about the only one not on stage, I think. Where's my right hand man?
Jimmy!
It's in here. It's in here on the top. Okay, thank you everybody. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves.